All right, hi everybody. So my name is David Yamron. I'm the Design Monitoring and Evaluation Coordinator on the Institutional Learning Team at Search for Common Ground. And today I'm going to be talking about a tool that we use called the SCORE Index, which we use to map social cohesion and coexistence in Liberia. So first, a quick introduction to Search for Common Ground. Search is the world's largest peacebuilding organization, founded in 1982. We have over 800 staff members spread across about 36 country offices. Our mission is to transform the way that the world deals with conflict away from adversarial approaches and towards cooperative solutions. So one of the really exciting tools that we've been using recently to achieve that goal is the Social Cohesion and Reconciliation Index, or the SCORE Index. It was developed by the UNDP, along with the Center for Sustainable Peace and Democratic Development, think tank SEED, with USAID funding. And essentially, it uses a process framework to guide the assessment of social cohesion and conflict-affected societies through multi-stakeholder collaboration. We're really interested in it because it combines participatory research processes with advanced data analysis in an attempt to identify drivers and root causes of conflict dynamics. So what does this look like in practice? There's four main stages to use of the SCORE methodology. The first is a participatory conceptual design, where a SCORE team will bring together local stakeholders, along with international development partners in a given country, and develop a series of indicators, context-specific indicators based on the country in question, bringing together global theoretical frameworks, along with, again, those regional or national issues. In stage two, the team will select and adapt those measurement instruments. So bringing together data from SCORE's past projects, indicators from those past projects, along with new indicators developed through that participatory mapping. Those indicators are then used to design an opinion poll. Stage three is the actual data collection and analysis, where the team will train enumerators and conduct the survey. Following that survey, which goes through multiple data streams, so collecting multiple data streams from general population, to youth, experts, et cetera, there's a predictive analysis done, where complex modeling attempts to, again, get at those underlying drivers of violent conflict. Stage four is a participatory policy dialogue, where those findings from the research are brought together, and the SCORE team will convene a series of workshops with local stakeholders, policy actors, and government actors to try and use those findings to develop specific policies and address those underlying conflict dynamics. So how does this work in practice? SCORE in Liberia was a partnership between Search for Common Ground and the UN mission in Liberia. The UN mission was preparing to depart Liberia in March 2018 and really wanted to understand what the situation would be like in order to hand something off to the Liberian government. This was a critical moment in Liberia's post-Civil War history, right? So the consolidation of peace following the Civil War, they're preparing for October 2017 presidential elections, as well as that March 2018 departure of the UN mission. So year one was the pilot phase in 2016 and 2017. There was that participatory mapping framework that I discussed, design of the opinion poll and survey, and then the actual survey itself. Search for Common Ground trained 22 enumerators who interviewed 2,300 people in all 15 regions of Liberia. In year two, there's a second round of data collection. The survey was expanded both in size and scope, so we added gender indicators as well as a governance assessment, and this time interviewed 6,200 respondents in February and March 2018. The results, after the data analysis was complete, were five policy briefs targeting five of the most significant findings in the report. These were on violent tendencies, civil trust and coexistence, development orientation, political tribalism, and then one specifically on implications of the UN mission's withdrawal. The SCORE team also developed five reconciliation plans in the countries identified by the survey to be most at risk of the outbreak of violent conflict. The Liberia Peacebuilding Office, who was the key government actor involved in this project, also used the results to guide the revision of the strategic roadmap for national healing, peacebuilding, and reconciliation. So let's take a look at some of the findings from one of those policy briefs, the violent tendencies one. So part of the survey revealed this was turned into this heat map here on violent tendencies. And the results, as you can see, reveal the national average for this index of violent tendencies from the survey at 1.9 on a scale of 0 to 10. This is, all things considered, a fairly promising score, especially in a post-conflict country. However, you can see there's significant regional variation in the results. So four counties in particular stand out as areas of concern due to average scores significantly higher than the average countrywide score. So understanding what contributes to these elevated scores is vital in order to tailor appropriate and effective policies. Further analysis of survey results diagnosed four main groups of indicators that predict violent tendencies. So you can see here these are governance and human security, intergroup harmony, psychosocial resilience, and political tribalism. The width or thickness of the arrows here reveal the strength of the relationship, and the colors of the arrows also correspond to the nature of the relationship. So blue arrows correspond to indicators that contribute to violent tendencies. Orange arrows correspond to indicators that impede violent tendencies. So you can see here some interesting things already. Political tribalism in particular is a strong contributor to violent tendencies. You can also see things like discrimination and physical insecurity as strong contributors, whereas cultural values of forgiveness, community cooperation, and family coherence impede development of violent tendencies. So you can see there's some clear implications for programming here. It helps us identify policy entry points with the highest likelihood of positive impact that can help address violent tendencies. In the short and medium term, what the search score team discovered was that the best policy interventions are things around good governance to increase social trust, effective security provision to decrease insecurity, improving human security, community cooperation. In the long-term scale, the policy interventions that the team, in consultation with local stakeholders, determined were the most effective policy interventions were an inclusive education experience, peace education, improving social healing, and developing executive skills. So we're really excited about this tool. This was a pilot in Liberia. From Search's perspective, this allows us to do program design on critical elements of conflict prevention and transformation. It helps us understand where to target what policies make the most sense in a context-specific setting. It also allows us to link individual-level factors to institutional characteristics, which is really exciting. And that's it. Thank you.